Greetings. I keep hearing an interesting idea proposed by liberal talking heads on TV.
Islam just needs a reformation like Christianity had.
But there are two words that sound similar and are both pretty long words. Reformation and restoration. Reformation. To reform or reform. To change. When people hear the phrase, the Reformation, they recall the movement to fix the Roman Catholic bureaucracy. This ultimately resulted in the protesters starting the Protestant or Protestant movement. The appropriate fact, however, is that this was an act of restoration. The Reformation worked because it was a restoration to the actual teachings of Jesus in the Bible, back to belief in the Word of God. But from the modern liberal perspective, the Reformation means a pacified or more peaceful religion. Liberals easily slip into this erroneous perception because they imagine the Crusades were wars of conquest. Pay attention, because this is still the modern narrative programming the sheeple. The Crusades were a response to over 300 years of militant Islamic expansion and war. The Crusades were the reaction then to exactly what we see today. Even in a smaller world, Islam murdered Christian pilgrims and Jews in the Holy Lands. So the Crusades were waged to turn back the cancerous violence of Muhammad's followers. No doubt the warriors probably caused collateral damage. War sucks. Don't want it? Then don't start it. And maybe, just maybe, the first step Islam can take is to destroy all mention of Dar al-Harb. Quit calling free nations the world of war. Just a thought. Getting back to reformation and restoration. Christianity could have a reformation to take us back to the Word of God. Liberals think Islam needs a reformation, but what they do not grasp is that they are watching it. ISIS, the Islamic State, Al-Qaeda, Boko Haram, Al-Shabaab. This is the Islamic Reformation. This is the Islamic Restoration. This is Islam returning to the true text of the Quran. Ever see a mousetrap set, ready to be triggered? Looks peaceful, right? But it is under tension. It is ready to violently release the energy stored in it. So is Islam. Followers of Islam all show this tension. ISIS, the Islamic State, Al-Qaeda, Boko Haram, Al-Shabaab, they simply represent the first wave of release of the energy in Islam. If you're a Christian, maybe you've wondered like I did, how could a one-world government and religion spring up so quickly in the last days? It's right there. Cheese. Have a bite. If you're a Christian, pray for the brothers and sisters who will continue to be murdered and crucified and beheaded by the Antichrist's religion. If you're a liberal or an anti-theist, I appeal to that tumor above your shoulders that you pride yourself with. If you cannot differentiate the current Islamic murder of innocents from the response of the Crusades 1,000 years ago, You have far less on the ball than you have convinced yourself that you have. Keep watching, and if you want the crib notes, find a Bible and start reading it. As Dirty Harry said, "You're not going to believe what happens next, even while it's happening." And if you call yourself Muslim and you have watched this much, I believe I understand your inner struggle. You are sincere in your heart, and you really may think you are following the true path to God. I really honestly think you may be sincere. You follow Islam because you were trained and conditioned to. But God has guided you to see this video so that you may begin to hear the truth. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.